Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today's video is a little different. We're not where I usually film. I just wanted to sit down and do the haul that I mentioned on my video, my previous video. Today I'm only going to show you the products and why I bought them. So if you would like to see them on my face and how they perform, then just go ahead and watch my previous video. And if you guys want to see how I created this look will be up on my social medias. I always leave my social medias linked down below. So go ahead and go watch this look. I'm probably going to do this video in two parts. This one, makeup, and then the second one, skincare. Like I mentioned before, I did buy new skincare. I'm super excited to try it out. Stay tuned for part two of this haul. Without further ado, let's get on to the haul. Okay. So the first product I'm going to talk about is these e.l.f. Total Face Sponges, that's what they're called. I prefer this sponge over the Beauty Blender and the Real Techniques, and it just makes your foundation look like skin. Honestly, my makeup game has changed a lot with these sponges. It just melts the foundation into my skin. It makes it seem like butter, and it makes it seem like I don't have a lot of foundation on, but it doesn't take away from your foundation, if that makes sense. You know, usually when you use a sponge, they do soak up a lot of foundation, reason why people like to use brushes, but this one doesn't. The little holes in it makes it so it doesn't soak up a lot of your product, which is good because then you're using less product. If you're looking for a sponge, if you're looking for something new, I recommend the e.l.f. sponges, and they're only $8 for two. $8 for two. The Real Techniques are like, what, $5? And Beauty Blenders are $20. So you get two for the price of not even a Beauty Blender. Beauty Blenders are $20. $8 for two sponges, that's a steal. So go ahead and go get it. Next, I want to talk about the Fit Me powders. As you guys know, I do use the loose setting powder in shade 10 to bake or like just set my concealer. I saw Daisy and she said that one of her makeup artists used these. And so I went out and got it, obviously. And oh my god, these powders have taken my makeup game to another level. So I use 220 to set all over my face. I used to set with the loose powder, but I noticed that it was a bit cracky and it would just dry me out. But this powder doesn't. And I think it's because it's pressed. So I just go in with a brush and just, you know, I'll just show you. I go in with my powder brush and just like set lightly. It blurs everything. It doesn't show any acne, any texture on your skin. And also, it just sets everything in place. It doesn't move whatsoever, so your makeup will stay in place the whole day. I got 355, and this one is coconut. And I use this one to contour, and wow, the same. Like, it's just the perfect shade, super bronzy. It just leaves me super, like, a seamless finish. Like, my skin has never looked this good, and it's because of the products. I did mention this in my last video, but you have to change your products so you can learn more about your skin. I know a lot of people don't like to because obviously I'm probably never going to change these because I know they just go with my skin so well. But you do have to try new products just to figure out your skin, figure out your face, figure out what you like, what you don't like. Products that will take your makeup game to the next level. A lot of products that haven't worked out for me in the past now work for me because of my skincare. I wear more makeup. If a product doesn't work for me, it might work for you. If a product works for me, it might not work for you. This is just what works with my skin. Next, I'm going to talk about the Dewy Finish by NYX. This has been my holy grail. My skin has never looked like this ever, ever, ever. Like, it doesn't leave me smile lines. I just love this setting mist. It just makes me super dewy. It makes my highlight blinding, and it just sets everything as well, and it will stay on for the rest of the day, I promise. I like to put my creams and then I spray it. Then I like to put my powders and then I spray it, and before my highlight application, I spray it again, which to some people might be, girl, you're spraying a lot. Yeah, I might be, but it just takes your makeup to the next level. Your makeup will look like skin and you won't have any patchiness, no texturized skin, nothing. Next is this Wet n Wild contouring palette. I purchased the Camo one. I've actually purchased the one before this one. It's the lighter one. There's only like three. This one is the middle one. And I got this one because the banana powder. The other one's like a pink slash like nude. I like banana just so my under eye can be brightened. I like to brighten my under eye. I did use this today. I'm just falling in love with all the products I bought, honestly. This one I use for my contour. So good. It makes me look super bronze and super caramel, super just, I'm here for it, I'm living. And then this one, honestly, to just brighten my under eye. Pink powders and banana powders do the same. It just depends on how you like your under eye. Go get this. This is like $4. Next, I got two mascaras. I got the Voluminous Lash Paradise, my usual one. But last time, it fell. But yeah, I decided not to get the waterproof. And I like this one better. It's not as clumpy and it holds. Honestly, I know some people say that waterproof mascaras hold curls better. But to me, this one holds my curls better, and I mean, I wear big ass lashes, so it doesn't really matter. Every day I do my makeup, I have to wear lashes, even if they're small. Like, small to me is kind of big to other people, if that makes sense. It's a dupe for the Better Than Sex Too Faced. It is a dupe, in my opinion. I used to use that one when I worked at Sephora, and it's $26, and this one's like $10. Next is the Telescopic Mascara by L'Oreal. I know two influencers that use this and swear by this. It's Jenny69 and then Carly Bible. I use this on my lower lashes. It makes it look super big. Like, my lashes look like if I'm wearing extensions, and I'm really not. It's just my lashes. So I know why Carly Bible and Jenny69 like it, because this mascara is super good. Next product is the Garnier Micellar Waters. I actually got both of them. I use this one in my morning routine or night routine when I take off my 2 pounds of makeup or when I wake up. And then I use this one before my application of actual makeup. I just like this one because it hydrates. This one does too, but I feel like this one, I need as much hydration as possible before my application of makeup and during my application of makeup. So I really like this one, and it just removes makeup, cleanses, and hydrates. And I just go in with the cotton pad and just take it off, and then same with this one, but at night or in the morning. So, and these are super inexpensive as well, like $7. Usually I would use like 2 Neutrogena makeup wipes, but now that I have the Micellar Waters, I just use one, and then I go in with my cotton pad and just use this and take off the rest of the makeup that was still there. Next is the e.l.f. Hydrating Camo Concealer. Oh my gosh, I don't know why it took me so long to get this, but they're always sold out. Honestly, like, the light colors are always sold out. So when I saw this one was the last one, and I snatched it. It's actually light beige. This is super hydrating. Like, it's crazy that it's a drugstore product. Honestly, e.l.f., you hit it out of the park with this, honestly, like, period. I've always said a drugstore has really good products. Honestly, you don't have to break the bank to get a beat face. 90% of my face was drugstore. Next product is Clear Brow and Lash Mascara by e.l.f. It looks like this. It's just a little tube. On this side, you have your brow gel. On this side, you have your lash mascara. It's clear. I just use both for my eyebrows. It keeps my eyebrows in place, and it's super cheap. This is $2. I can't do my brows without this anymore. Like, I can't do my brows without setting them with the gel or Havon. I have to set my brows with something. Even hairspray, I've done it. Yes, I've done it. When you set your eyebrows, you'll see that your eyebrow game will change. I can do my eyebrows without setting them. It just keeps them in place, and it makes it look more like hair, more furry, more just a good brow. An Instagram brow, or you can do a natural brow. Whatever you want to do, you can do it with this. Next, I got the Ofra Highlighter in Rodeo Drive. I got a big one. If you guys watched my last videos, you guys know that I love Rodeo Drive, and yes, me estaba acabando. I almost finished it in my last palette, which is like the medium size, so I had to get a big size. But yeah, this is how it looks. It's super beautiful. You can either do minimal and put a little bit, or you can go all extra and highlight yourself to the gods. This is my favorite highlighter in the entire world. Ofra, please never discontinue it, because I probably will cry. Another thing from Ofra that I used today that I'm super excited about is the Ofra Verified Liquid Liner. Oh my god. The felt tip on this, super good. Let me show you. Like, you can draw anything that you want. Anything. Like, this is gonna help me with my inner corner. I'm so excited to do inner corners again. I do like my e.l.f. one, but I think it's a little hard. But with this, I think it's gonna be super easier. And it was super easy to do my wing liner. Like, I did it super fast in like 2 minutes. I was shocked. So if you're looking for a good eyeliner, highly recommend this one. It is like $20, but I bought it when Yvette XO was having a sale. She partnered up with Ofra and they had a 40% sale. So I actually got it for $8, which is a freaking steal. Next is the Rose Water 3-in-1 Primer Water. I always mess up saying this name because the name is so long, but it's the Wet n Wild. My tongue. But it's the Wet n Wild Photo Focus Rose 3-in-1 Primer Water. You can use this to prep, set, and refresh. So it just looks like this. It smells like roses. It smells like rose petals. I love it. These are super good. The only thing I dislike is they are super small. So you are getting a little bit of product, but they're only like $6. You get what you paid for, basically. I like it to prime. And I like it to refresh. I don't use this to set my face because I do use my next one just so I can be super dewy. But this does make you dewy and it does hydrate. So it's basically the same, but I feel like the next one makes me more dewy and it just makes my face super set, if that makes sense. But I do love both. The rest are just lipsticks. It's basically all nudes. They're all from L'Oreal. The only downfall about these, they're not super long lasting, but if you're someone like me, I always reapply my lipstick just because I like to have my lipstick there. But what I love about these products is they're super creamy and they just, the perfect nudes. I love these nudes. The first one and my favorite nude at the moment right now is 974. And I'm gonna swatch them on my hand so you guys can see. It's just like nude. It's a really cute nude. This is the one I'm using on my lips right now, and then I just went over with the gloss. Okay, so the next one is 981. This one's like more brown. So this one is a little darker than this one, obviously. It's just like more brown. More like a cocoa type of color, more chocolatey, I guess, just a darker brown. And they're super creamy, like super creamy. I love this formula. If they could make it long lasting, this would probably be my favorite lipsticks, because right now they are. But if they could make the formula more long lasting, these are it. And I don't see a lot of influencers talking about them, maybe because they're not super long lasting, but these are super creamy. So if you're looking for good lipsticks for cheap or a reasonable price, look into these. And then this one is $9.85. This one's like a pinky, more pinky, yeah, nude. So it's like a rosy pink. And then last one is $9.78. And this used to be my favorite before I found $9.74. And this one is like a brown pinky. So they're super creamy, super hydrating. They don't dry out your lips and they make them look super good. So highly recommend these two. Next is, I haven't used these. I think the rest I haven't used other than the lip liner. The rest of the things that I've used are these lip liners by NYX. You guys already know that I love the NYX lip liners. In my opinion, they're dupes for the MAC ones. Obviously the MACs are more creamy, but for the price, it's not bad. It's not bad at all. I actually used Moonwalk today and it's like a brown. It's just like a brown. And then Downtown Beauty, it is a brown as well, but this one's more lighter. So this one's like darker. They're both really good liners. To you, they might look the same, but I swear they're different, as you guys can tell, see. This one's like more brown, and then this one's like brown with like a burgundy undertone. Honestly, you can use makeup for whatever you want. And makeup is so versatile. There's no rules to makeup. If you like a brush that's a face brush for your eyes, do you. As long as you're doing and feeling beautiful, doing the most, do you, there's no rules to makeup and you can do whatever you want to do with makeup. That's why I love makeup so much. Okay, so I only have 5 products left and they're all lip products that I haven't used, but I'm excited to use. So I got these two and they're the NYX Lingerie Push-Up. I've heard really good things about these. Oh, that's so pretty. Yeah. Okay, so this one's like a pinky nude. A pinky nude, I really like it. I'm excited to use it. I love the formula on this. So next is this brown. Oh, I love this brown. I've been wanting to try this out. It's a little dark maybe to like put on your lips, but it's a good way to overline your lips. Next is the Maybelline. I've heard really good things about this and I've never used them, so I needed to grab one and I got it in the shade 65. Victor actually helped me choose this one. I was between two colors, lighter than this one and then this one, and I was like, babe, which one do you like more? And he was like, that one. And I was like, really? And he was like, yeah. I think he just said it so we could fucking leave because he was over me shopping. Let's see how this one. Ooh, this one's pretty. I have not swatched them because I wanted to wait to do this video so you guys could see my reaction to them, but this is so cute. Oh my gosh, I'm so excited to play with makeup more now. I love buying new makeup because I get so excited and so inspired to play with more color, more just like play with my face and figure out my face even more. Actually, I might put it right now. Let's see how it looks like glossy. Oh, it smells so good. Okay, I don't recommend you eating it, but it smells so good. Oh my god, this is so pretty. I think, okay, this might be my favorite shade now. And the applicator, look at the applicator. It's like a different applicator. I really like this applicator. Yep. Okay, for sure gonna use this more. Love this nude. Maybelline's so good. All the drugstores, honestly, they're super good. I love the products, I love the brands because they're super inexpensive. Okay, the next one is Anofra lipstick as well. This one's like a nude too. Let's see. Okay, these look very similar. Super similar. This one looks more, this one is for sure more pinky, but they're super similar and they're both matte lipsticks, so they'll both dry down to a matte formula. Last but not least is these two Revlon lipsticks. Like I said, nudes. Your girl likes nudes, I'm sorry. That's just what I gravitate towards. I remember before I used to do like extreme lipsticks. Like I remember I would wear like purples, like super purple. I think I wore once like black, blue. Yeah, I wore blue my freshman year. Oh my god, I wore blue. I was just like something else. Maria was living her best life with the colors and I was there for it, obviously. Okay, so the first shade is number 645. Let's see, where can I put it? I dead ass got a lot that look similar. I mean, all nudes to me look very similar. This one looks honestly like the Maybelline, but it's super creamy as well. Ooh, has like a little like sheen to it. That's so cute. Like when it hits the light, it has a little sheen, or maybe it's because it's drying down. No, it does have a little sheen. That's cute. Here for it. And the last one is 630. And this one's lighter. This is like a pinky nude. Yeah. This one's way lighter. So you can always, what I like to do, oh my god, that's so gorgeous. Hold up. These are very similar. All nude. Your girl. I'm obsessed with nudes. I have a problem. We reached the end of the haul. Let me know if you guys want to see more chit chats, more hauls, more vlogs on my channel. I would love to do that. Also, if you have any other ideas, leave them in the comments down below. I always read through them and respond back. I will do part 2 of this haul when my skincare gets here. Thank you for loving me. Thank you for loving my content. And if you're not subscribed, please subscribe so you can join the glam family. Give this video a like, comment, and hit that bell notification so you guys get notified every single time I upload. I do upload every Thursday, so don't miss out. I love you guys so much, and see you in the next video.